जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय गोपी जना बल्लभा गिरिवरधारी, जय गोपी जना बल्लभा गिरिवरधारी, यशोदनंदना ब्रज जनरंजना, यशोदनंदना ब्रज जनरंजना, यमुना तीरावनचारी, यमुना तीरावनचारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, जय प्रभुपदा प्रभुपदा श्रील प्रभुपदा प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद, जय जय प्रभुपाद, जय श्री हरि नाम संकीर्तन की जय, श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय, अनंत कोटि वैष्णव भक्त वृंद की जय, जय निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल, हरे कृष्णा। ओम ज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः, श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं, नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी निति नामिने, नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे, निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे, वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च, पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। Hare Krishna. So I'm very happy to be able to serve all of you by having this opportunity to speak on a very important festival in our Gaudiya Vaishnava tradition. This is a festival whose celebration helps us focus on the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, which is received through the medium of his devotees and the spiritual master. So in the month of Ashad, or I think it is the end of Jeshta, sometime in the month of June, every year we celebrate the Chida Dahi Mahotsav. The festival of Chida Dahi. And for most of us who have grown up in the Gaudiya Vaishnava tradition, this is a festival that helps us pray for mercy. At the same time, we get to eat nectarian Chida Dahi too, flat rice and yogurt. So, about 550 years ago, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, let's say 500 years ago, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, had descended from the spiritual world as the Yuga Avatar, he came along with Sri Nityananda Prabhu. And Narottam Das Thakur has sung that the same Krishna, who is the son of Nanda Maharaj, has now appeared as the son of Sachi Devi. And Sri Balaram has appeared as Nityananda Prabhu. Brajendra Nandana Jai Shachi Shuta Haila Shi Balarama Haila Nita Balarama Haila Nita. So the son of Mother Shachi is none other than Krishna. However, in this avatar, in his present form as the son of Shachi, he is called as Shachi Suta. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's name is also Sri Shachi Suta. And Balarama Hoilo Nitai. Sri Balaramji is Nityananda Prabhu. So the tattva of Nityananda Prabhu is very important for the Gaudiya Vaishnavas to understand. Most of us know that the tattva of Nityananda Prabhu or Sri Balaram is very important. Sri Balaramji is Krishna himself. He is the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, just a different form. Sarvavatare Krishna Swayam Bhagavan Tanhera Dvitya Rupa Shri Balarama. So Krishna is Sarvavatari. He's the source of all incarnations. And his second form is Shri Balaram. So the Acharyas say that Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the personality of Godhead that receives service. So he's called as Sevya Bhagavan. And Shri Balaram is his second form. And he is the personality of Godhead that renders service, or Sevaka Bhagavan. So because Shri Balaramji is Sevaka Bhagavan, or he is the embodiment of service unto the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, therefore he is also the Guru Tattva, because one of the characteristics of the Guru or spiritual master is that he is in perfect knowledge. He or she is in perfect knowledge of rendering pleasing service to Krishna, which is unmotivated and unrestricted. So now, Balaramji is Sevaka Bhagavan, he is the Guru Tattva, he is the original spiritual master. So he knows how to serve Krishna, so such that Krishna is pleased, and he is also the perfect personality to teach other living entities the art of serving Krishna. That is Sri Balaram. So in Chaitanya Leela, Sri Balaram has appeared as Sri Nityananda Prabhu. So it goes without saying that the mercy of Sri Nityananda Prabhu is of paramount importance in the life of every practitioner or sadhaka in Krishna consciousness. In another song, bhajan, a devotional song or bhajan, Narottam Das Thakur, he glorifies Nityananda Prabhu by saying, Heno nitai bine bhai, Radha Krishna paite na. Dridha kori dharo nitai pai. Dridha kori dharo nitai pai. Hano nitai bine bhai. He's addressing all of the followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, those who are practicing Krishna consciousness, and calling them very endearingly as, "Oh brother, dear sir, without the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, one would not be able to receive the blessings of Radha and Krishna." And the reason is, Shri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the combined form of Shri Shri Radha and Krishna. So, Narottam Das Thakur is declaring that without the mercy, the blessings, the permission, or a favorable glance of Shri Nityananda Prabhu, it is absolutely difficult, or rather impossible, to receive the blessings of Radha and Krishna, who have now appeared in the combined form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Hence, one must try and successfully hold on to the lotus feet of Sri Nityananda Prabhu, which is the reservoir of all mercy, of blessings. The lotus feet of Lord Nityananda Prabhu is the reservoir of spiritual strength, spiritual intelligence. So, to serve Krishna, one needs to have purified intelligence. One needs to find spiritual strength to be able to say no to material allurements and yes to spiritual services. So we need intelligence, we need strength, we need mercy, we need blessings, and all of that resides at the lotus feet of Sri Nityananda Prabhu. So Dridha Kori, with sincere determination, one must hold on to the lotus feet of Lord Nityananda. So with that, we'll come to the pastime of the distribution of Chida Dahi to all the devotees that happened many, many years ago, centuries ago, in the holy town of Panihati. So there was a very sincere follower of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who since his very early childhood was attracted to the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. He lived in a city in Bengal called Adi Saptagram. He was born in a very affluent family. His father and his uncle, they were landlords and very senior tax collectors on behalf of the local government. This was the Majumdar family. And the two brothers, Hiranya and Govardhan Majumdar, they were very rich, and also they were very favorable to Vaishnavas and to the Vaishnava culture. So the son of Hiranya Majumdar, who also was the only child of the family of these two brothers, was named Raghunath. And Raghunath, since his early childhood, was inclined to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his philosophy. In fact, his mind and his heart had been completely won over simply by hearing the description of Lord Chaitanya's beautiful form and his practice of Harinama Sankirtan. And he always was very eager to receive the audience of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Being a little boy, he did not have that opportunity. Time passed. As a young man who was in his teens, he got an opportunity to visit Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he was in Shantipur. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had taken sannyas by then. He had taken the renounced order of life. And young Raghunath, seeing the beautiful form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as a young sannyasi, his mind was convinced, or he was convinced in his mind, that he should also take up to the renounced order of life. Sometimes we are influenced by the circumstances and the surroundings in where we live, because those circumstances and surroundings are very impactful and powerful. However, those strong feelings, they end just as they are born. Since those feelings arise in the heart at one point of time, there is a greater possibility that those feelings would decline and end too, which is the nature with any feelings that we, or emotions that we go through in this life. So unless and until one has made the mind very strong through sincere practice and determination, one would have such fleeting emotions constantly plaguing us or ravaging us or affecting us. Some of those emotions are favorable for spiritual advancement, and some of those are favorable towards material advancement. So those that are favorable for material advancement are not beneficial for spiritual advancement. Material advancement is inversely proportional to spiritual advancement. We are not speaking of material benefits here or material status. We are speaking of consciousness. So more the consciousness is affected materially, that is inversely proportional to being motivated spiritually. The more one's consciousness is spiritually inclined, the lesser one would be inclined towards material distractions. This is how it is. This is how it works. So when the young man was just in his teenage years, very shyly proposed to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that he was very, very eager to join him as a renunciate, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave him instructions, which the gist of those instructions was that Raghunath should try and cultivate real renunciation, and he should not be influenced by fleeting renunciation. Fleeting renunciation is called as Markat Vairagya, the renunciation of a monkey. Markat Vairagya is a terminology used in Niti Shastras. Niti Shastras, they give us various moral lessons. So Markat Vairagya. Markat Vairagya Nyaya means real renunciation is exhibited by strength of one's determination, whereas fleeting renunciation is simply an emotional experience that one is going through. And fleeting renunciation is called as Markat Vairagya. So Raghunath, he took Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instructions to heart. He felt encouraged by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's concern for him. He wasn't dejected at all, because he had no pride. He did not have any material ambitions or goals. He did not have any other ulterior motives. He had a very simple desire. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, understanding that the life of a renunciate has many challenges, he expressed to Raghunath that Raghunath should try and cultivate more determination within his mind before he took up to a life of renunciation. So Raghunath understood what Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was expressing. So he went back home. And when he was at home, he performed all of his duties as was necessary. However, within his heart, he was cultivating renunciation, which is a very interesting art. To be able to perform one's duties without being attached to the outcome of the results, and at the same time, doing one's duties the best of one's ability, it requires a very strong intelligence and a very strong mind. So these are subject matters that are discussed in the Bhagavad Gita. So we will not discuss philosophy as much today. There was an incident wherein his uncles, who had been trying to save a little more money while returning the taxes that they were collecting on behalf of the government, they tried to save a little more money for themselves incognito. And another gentleman who was competing for their position, who was a Turk, he became aware of their shady dealings. So he informed the government, the minister in charge, and this was so serious that the minister himself came to Adi Saptagram along with this Turk, and they went to the house of the Majumdars. But the local well-wishers of the Majumdars had already informed the brothers that the government official is aware and is coming to to arrest them, they made their escape. They went into hiding. Raghunath had no idea about these dealings. He was at home, a young boy, young enough to be called an adult. So the minister, when he saw that the brothers were not there in the house, so the minister, he handed over the affairs to the local Turk, and he left. So the Turk, becoming angry that the Majumdar brothers could not be captured, he asked the soldiers to imprison Raghunath. But however, Raghunath was put under house imprisonment, and the Turk, he started living in that house for a couple of days till the matter could be sorted out. So Raghunath, he dealt with the Turk in such a wonderful way that the Turk felt that Raghunath was, the Turk could understand that Raghunath was not only innocent, but he was such a gentle person. And at one point of time, the Turk really felt bad that he had mistreated Raghunath, and he had tears in his eyes, and he said that you are just like my son. And he actually felt that Raghunath was just like his dependent, his son, and he shouldn't be mistreating him. So somehow he sent a message to the minister that Raghunath is innocent, and he had Raghunath freed. And then he told Raghunath that you should arrange a meeting with your father and your uncle, and we can sort out matters so that whatever money is being saved without the government's knowing, they can share among themselves. So Raghunath, he got that meeting arranged, and things were sorted out. So seeing that Raghunath had dealt with the situation in such a mature way, his parents were convinced that now Raghunath could take over the business. However, what happened was that within a few days of this taking place, Raghunath had such a strong emotion of wanting to just give up all of these material dealings that he ran away from his house in the middle of the night. His parents were aware of his aspirations of renouncing his material life, so they were not agreeable to it, his parents and his uncle. So they had guards sent after him, their personal guards. And these guards, they captured Raghunath and brought him back. However, almost every second day or third day, Raghunath would find an excuse and he would try and escape. And because his father and uncle had a lot of clout in the neighboring areas and districts, Raghunath would be captured. And Raghunath would try to escape on foot, whereas his father's guards would have a better means of transport, of travel. So he would be captured. So finally, his mother gets so tired of having to deal with her son, her only son, wanting to run away, and then he having to be captured and brought back to the house, and her son completely being disinterested in his household affairs. She suggested to her husband, who was Raghunath's father, that we should tie him up with a rope, and we should bind him up and keep him in the house. That way, at least, we don't have to run after him when he escapes. And his father said something very interesting, which it is very striking, which we would like to, all of us would be affected by. This is in Bengali. This is in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Kaviraj Goswami makes this statement. He says, Indra sama Aishwarya stri apsara sama esa bandhite nari likhai yanramana. Our son Raghunath has the opulences like the heavenly king Indra. And he has a beautiful wife whose beauty is on par with the heavenly ladies, the apsaras. Now, typically, Kanchan and Kamini, or wealth and attraction to the opposite sex, are severe distractions in this material world, because they capture one's imagination in this material world. You know, there's a story of, it's just a humorous story of a simpleton in a village winning the lottery jackpot for about $100 million. Being a huge sum of money, the officials were concerned that the simpleton may not be able to handle the finances properly. And this could be such a shock, a shocker to him, that maybe he would not be able to sustain the emotional impact that I have received $100 million as cash prize. So they asked the local priest to help. So the local priest tried to come up with a presentation, and accordingly, he broke the message to this simpleton, the simple farmer. He broke the news to the simple farmer, but he tried to stagger it. He said, if you receive some money, let's say if you receive about 500,000 rupees, what would you do with it? And the farmer said, well, I could use it on the land, and I could try and work on the house. So I think I could do a lot with 500K. So then the priest, he says, what if you get 1 million? He says, 1 million, maybe I would really kind of work, you know, do the build a bigger house, maybe buy more cattle, do things on the land. So yeah, I could do with $1 million too. What if you receive 10 million? And the farmer is like, shut up, you know, it's, come on, 10 million. Who gets 10 million just like that? He says, no, what if you have 10 million? He says, well, if I have 10 million, that maybe I'll buy a very high-end car, or maybe some other facilities. You know, maybe another farm or a ranch, hire some more people. Then the priest says, what if you get 50 million? And the farmer says, I think you'd better go away. I mean, you're just trying to make a fool of me. And he says, no, what if 50 million? He says, I don't know what if I get 50 million. Maybe there is some way I could use it. Maybe, you know, maybe if I think a lot, maybe there's some way I could use that kind of money too. So then the father says, all right, what if you get, the priest says, what if you get $100 million? And he says, if I get $100 million, half of that I'll give it to you. And the priest has a heart attack. The priest was not able to fathom how he could not, his emotional state was not geared up to handle $50 million of cash. So he had a heart attack. So wealth, you know, $1 million, you could be a renunciate. $100 million, the mind could play tricks. So wealth. And then there is the attraction to the opposite sex. So Kanchan and Kamini. And Raghunath had the best of both. So his father says that if this is not able to bind him, tie down his mind, then what would a physical rope do? Because the mind is more powerful than physical elements. The mind has, it comes up with so many ways that can overcome physical limitations. So his mind is completely attracted to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we have to accept this fact. He is bound by the ropes of affection to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So our son, in one way, is lost. This is what he spoke to his wife. But when dealing with Raghunath, he was convinced that Raghunath had to stay with him. So he wouldn't let Raghunath go. One day Raghunath heard that Sri Nityananda Prabhu had come to the town of Panihati. He requested his father that he could go and pay his respects to Sri Nityananda Prabhu. So in those days, people would travel on foot. So Panihati, the town of Panihati, was about a half a day's walk, or if you could find some horse ride or a bullock cart ride, then it could save you some time. So it was a half a day to a day's walk or a journey from Adi Saptagram to Panihati. So his father felt that it was all right because his father also respected Nityananda Prabhu. His father was also very respectful to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It was just that he did not want his son to accept the renounced order, because he was the only son, the heir to their empire. So Raghunath went to visit Nityananda Prabhu. And when he entered the town of Panihati and he was approaching the place where he had received information that Nityananda Prabhu was staying, from a distance he saw Lord Nityananda sitting on the banks of the river Ganga on this rocky patch of terrain, like a boulder, a big boulder. On the banks of the river Ganga, which was, and this rocky seat was shaded over by an expensive banyan tree, Ashwatthama tree, expansive. So see, and then Nityananda Prabhu was surrounded by so many followers and all of them looked so effulgent and so serene and so focused. It appeared as if they were all sages. And Nityananda Prabhu was like the topmost of all the sages. So from a distance, Raghunath, he offered his obeisances to Nityananda Prabhu, and feeling unqualified to approach him any further, he stayed away at that distance. Lord Nityananda was informed that Raghunath has come, but he is keeping some distance. Lord Nityananda roared. He said, oh, he is a thief. Because only thieves, they feel uncomfortable and stay away from a crowd. So he's a thief. And I must punish a thief. So bring him to me. So some of the devotees, they walked up to Raghunath and they informed him that Lord Nityananda is wanting you to be in his presence. And feeling very, very unqualified, with his head bowed down and his eyes pointing to the ground, Raghunath approached Lord Nityananda very meekly. And when he was very close to Lord Nityananda, he just fell down onto the ground and offered him prostrated obeisances. And Lord Nityananda, he placed his lotus feet on his head and laughing in a very transcendental way, he said, "You are a thief and therefore I must punish you. Your punishment is that you must feed all of us with chidadahi, flat rice and mixed with yogurt and a sweetener like sugar or some other sweetener." Raghunath was so ecstatic. He was so happy. So he made elaborate arrangements. He was the son of a landlord. He had loads of money. So he consulted with a few of his own men. They went to the local market. They made inquiries. They bought earthen pots and all the ingredients that were needed to make chidadahi. They got flat rice, they got milk, they purchased condensed milk, they purchased sugar, they purchased bananas, and especially a local flavored banana, a banana which had this really special flavor, which was local to that place. It was called as champakala, camphor, and whatever other spices and condiments that would be needed to flavor the preparation. And then he asked a very qualified brahmana to specially prepare chidadahi for Lord Nityananda. And for that purpose, he purchased 5 to 7 big earthen pots. And then there is a very elaborate process that has been described. Two kinds of preparations were made. In both the preparations, the flat rice was soaked in hot milk for a few moments till it became a little soft. And then the milk was drained away. And then to one pot or to one preparation was added yogurt, sugar, and the spices like camphor and lychee and so on and so forth. And to the other preparation, to the other, the other half of the soaked flat rice, that was mixed with condensed milk, camphor, special kind of banana called as champakala, and other spices. There was also clarified butter added to it, ghee. And these were like exotic preparations. So 7 pots were placed in front of Lord Nityananda, and every person who was accompanying Lord Nityananda was given 2 substantially big pots, one with the mix of yogurts, flat rice, sugar, and spices, and the other was with the mix of with condensed milk, champakala, camphor, and other ingredients. Everyone was so happy receiving these pots. And then Lord Nityananda, he took his bath, he put on fresh clothes, He came and sat down on that raised platform along with many other senior personalities. And within his mind, he invoked the presence of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared, and those who were fortunate enough, they could see that Lord Chaitanya had appeared in Panihati. At that time, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was living in Jagannath Puri, which was like hundreds of miles away. But the Lord appeared on Nityananda Prabhu's request. And then Nityananda Prabhu, he took a morsel, a handful of this Chidadahi preparation from one pot, and he put it into the mouth of Lord Chaitanya, feeding him. Lord Chaitanya, understanding that Nityananda Prabhu was in this playful mood, he followed suit. He also picked up a handful from another pot and he fed Nityananda Prabhu. And then the two brothers, they got up from their seat and they walked amongst the assembly of devotees. And they went from one person to the other. And Nityananda Prabhu was feeding Lord Chaitanya from one pot, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was feeding Lord Nityananda from another pot. This was like the two lords in a transcendental way accepting the bhoga. And then when some of the people saw just Lord Nityananda moving around and doing things with their pots, they were amazed. And others who could see Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda being playful for each other, they felt so fortunate and thankful that they could see the sight. Then Lord Nityananda, he came back along with Lord Chaitanya and they sat on that raised platform. And then Lord Nityananda, he roared out, inviting all the devotees to begin the feast. He said, "Chant Hari, Hari." And there was this tumultuous sound of Hari, Hari resounding in all the directions. And Mother Ganga, she felt so happy seeing this conglomeration of exemplary personalities. Many other people from the neighborhood and neighboring villages, they heard that there was a festival. They started pouring in. Some of the merchants from the neighboring villages started pouring in. Raghunath would purchase all their wares from the merchants, and to the others who came in, he offered them two pots of Chidadahi and asked them to participate in the festival. And after he had purchased the wares from the merchants, he also gave them two pots and asked them to also sit down and participate in the festival. Meanwhile, Raghav Pandit, who is a resident of Panihati and a dear follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he approached Lord Nityananda, who was sitting under this tree on the banks of the river Ganges. And by the time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had disappeared, because everyone was now honoring Prashad, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had gone back to Jagannath Puri. So Raghav Pandit comes in and he started laughing and he says, "Dear sir, I have so many preparations waiting for you at my house. All of them prepared in clarified butter and ghee. And you're sitting here and you're honoring Chidadahi. I find that a little astounding." And Lord Nityananda said, "I like the preparations that you make at your house. And what I suggest is that right now we can all eat Chidadahi, and whatever preparations you have made, we can have that in the evening as supper. And it is all right because I'm a cowherd boy and I like to sit down with all of my friends on the banks of the river and have a picnic like this, enjoy a picnic like this." And all the devotees who were there, they felt as if Panihati had been transformed into Vrindavan. And they were sitting on the banks of the Yamuna and they were enjoying their picnic lunches, just as when Krishna would enjoy their lunch pastimes 5,000 years ago when he had appeared on this earth planet. So Raghav Pandit was also given two pots. He sat down to eat. And after Nityananda Prabhu had eaten and everyone else had eaten, Nityananda Prabhu got up and he ate of three pots, and four pots he had kept for Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya had eaten of those four pots. So he took those four pots and he gave it to Raghunath, and he told him, this is Mahaprasad for you. And then Lord Nityananda, he left for Prakshalam, for Hastamukha Prakshalam, to wash his hands and mouth. And the three pots that Nityananda Prabhu was eating of, they also had remnants in them. So Raghunath, they took the four pots of offerings that had been given to him by Lord Nityananda and distributed all of that amongst the devotees, and everyone got a morsel. And then of the three pots that Lord Nityananda had eaten of, he distributed it amongst his own men. And then he also partook of it. In the evening, after that, Lord Nityananda came back. He was often offered mouth fresheners, fresh garland, and sandalwood paste. And everyone was doing kirtan. And then they took some rest. And in the evening, they all gathered at the house of Raghava Pandit. And at the house of Raghava Pandit, they had such wonderful kirtan. Lord Chaitanya appeared and he simply watched Lord Nityananda dance. And Lord Nityananda saw that Lord Chaitanya had appeared, and he felt more ecstatic, and he danced for the pleasure of Lord Nityananda, and he encouraged for the pleasure of Lord Chaitanya, and he encouraged all the devotees to dance ecstatically too. Raghava Pandit was, Raghunath Das, along with Raghava Pandit, was watching the surreal sankirtan and dance of Sri Chaitanya, of Sri Nityananda Prabhu and his associates. After some time, Nityananda Prabhu was requested by Raghava Pandit to take rest and now to have some supper. Nityananda Prabhu accepted his request. All the devotees, they went and they took a wash. They put on fresh clothes. And then Nityananda Prabhu and his associates sat down to eat supper. And after they had the supper, which was a glorious supper, and there's such a description about this supper. Raghava Pandit, many devotees, they were asking for Raghunath and saying that, please ask Raghunath to come and sit down and take prasad with us. And Raghava Pandit said, he has some important work. He will take prasad later on. You all please continue. And after everyone had taken prasad and they had gone to take some rest, Raghava Pandit, he called Raghunath and he offered the remnants of Lord Nityananda. And he blessed him with these words. He said, by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, very soon all of your desires will be fulfilled. I know that it is your desire to meet Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And after receiving the mercy of Sri Nityananda Prabhu, you will definitely be able to go and meet Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and stay with him. Raghunath was so happy to hear those words of blessings from Raghava Pandit. That night, the devotees rested, and the next day, Lord Nityananda, after he had finished his morning duties, he went and sat under that tree again, and all the devotees were surrounding him. The senior devotees were sitting with him on the raised platform, and Raghunath very meekly, he approached Sri Nityananda Prabhu and he started offering his prayers to Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu, when he saw Raghunath, he was so very happy to see Raghunath, and he was completely satisfied by Raghunath's offering the previous night. So Raghunath, he approached Nityananda Prabhu. He worshipped him. And he offered his prayers of supplication. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is said, Adhama Pamaramui Hina Jiva Dhamma Mora Ichha Hoye Pana Chaitanya Charana. I am the lowest of men, the most sinful, fallen and condemned. Nevertheless, I desire to attain shelter at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Vamana hona yena chanda dhari bare chaya aneka yatna kaino tate kabhu siddhanaya. Just like a dwarf who tries to catch the moon, I have tried my best many times, but I have never been successful. Every time I try to give up my home and give up my possessions and run away, my father and mother, unfortunately, they kept me bound. Dear sir, said Raghunath, Tomara kripa vina keha chaitanya na paya, tumi kripa kaile tanre adhameya paya. He said, my dear sir, no one can attain the shelter of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu without your mercy. But if you are merciful, even the lowest of men can attain the shelter at his lotus feet, at the shelter of his lotus feet. Ayogya moini vedana korite kori bhaya more chaitanya deha gosai anasadaya. Although I am the most unqualified, I am unfit and greatly afraid to submit this plea, I nevertheless request you, sir, to be especially merciful toward me by granting me shelter at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Kindly place your feet on my head. Give me the benediction that I may achieve the shelter of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu without difficulty. I pray for this benediction. Nityananda Prabhu, when he heard Raghunath Das speaks in such a humble manner, he was so pleasantly surprised. He laughed and then smilingly, he told all the devotees, Raghunath Das's material happiness, the standard of his material happiness is equal to that of Indra, the king of heaven. Having been bestowed by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Raghunath Das, although situated in such material happiness, does not like it at all. Therefore, let every one of you be merciful towards him and give him the benediction that he may very soon attain shelter at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna Pada Padma Gandha Ye Janapaya Brahma Loka Adi Sukha Tandre Nahi Bhaya. This is very interesting, which is very inspirational. One who experiences the fragrance of the lotus feet of Lord Krishna does not value even the standard of happiness available in Brahma Loka, the topmost planet, and what to speak of the heavenly happiness of the demigods. So, every living entity has the opportunity, because every living entity intrinsically, constitutionally, is a servant of Krishna and is naturally attracted towards Krishna. Somehow or the other, we have forgotten our natural affection towards Krishna. However, once that natural affection and attraction to Krishna becomes aroused, becomes awakened, then the mind and the senses would be completely overwhelmed by this presence of Krishna in our lives. The experience would be so amazing that none of the happiness of this material world, or all of the happiness of the material world put together, could influence even a fragment of our mind or senses. Our intelligence would not be bewildered, or even a portion of our intelligence would not be bewildered by these distractions, because Krishna, after all, is all attractive. The only personality who is absolutely and completely all attractive, and hence is called Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, Nityananda Prabhu requested all of the devotees to bless Raghunath. Raghunath received the blessings of all of the devotees. Then Sri Nityananda Prabhu placed his lotus feet on the head of Raghunath as he was offering obeisances. This is a very special mercy which is understood by the followers of the Vedic tradition. The lotus feet of the Lord is extremely benedicting and powerful. And hence, if we get the opportunity to receive the lotus feet of the Lord on our heads, It is called this process where the Lord places his lotus feet on our head is called as Atma Nivedanam, or offering oneself completely unto Krishna. The dust of the lotus feet of the Lord can destroy all the material ambitions that distract the living entities in this world. Just the dust of the lotus feet of the Lord. Charan Raj. That's how powerful the lotus feet of the Lord are. Dear Raghunath Das, since you arranged the feast on the bank of the Ganges, of the Ganga, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here just to show his mercy. And by his causeless mercy, by his own independent desire, he ate the chipped rice and milk. And then he saw the Sankirtan, the dancing of all the devotees at night. He also took supper at the house of Raghava Pandit. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Toma Udharite Gaura Aila Apane, Chutila Tomar Jata Vigna Adi Bandhane. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Gaura Hari, came here personally to deliver you. Now rest assured that all the impediments meant for your bondage are gone. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will definitely accept you and place you under the charge of his secretary, Swarup Damodar. You will thus become one of his most confidential internal servants and will attain shelter at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. These words, these prophetic words, prove to be true. And Raghunath Das, he spent 12 years under the guidance of Swarup Damodar Goswami, serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very, very intimately in Sri Jagannath Puri. And in this way, Sri Raghunath Das Goswami's heart's desire was fulfilled. So this is the glory of this festival, the Chiradahi Bohatsav or the Chiradahi festival, which makes one reflect on one's own sincerity, determination. How with sincere endeavor and strong determination, one must practice one's sadhana. And at the same time, one must beseech and take shelter of great personalities, the Mahajanas, and especially the Supreme Personality of Godhead who appears, who resides in the heart of every living entity as the Chaitya Guru, the spiritual master in the heart of every living entity, and manifests himself in the form of the Diksha Guru and the Siksha Gurus, who personally guide us in our practices of Krishna consciousness. So with our own endeavors, the mercy of devotees, especially the spiritual masters who are representing Sri Nityananda Prabhu, and receiving the grace of Sri Nityananda Prabhu and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one will, after so many lifetimes of having suffered in this material world, one would go back to the lotus feet of Sri Sri Radha's Shyama Sundar and serve them to our heart's content for time immemorial, forever and ever and ever. And the pleasure that one gets is ever increasing. Anandam buddhi vardhanam pratipadam purna amritaswadhanam. So Srila Prabhupada has given us this wonderful literature, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. He introduced us to these beautiful festivals, which are festivals of mercy, wherein one can once again reaffirm our determination, our sincerity. One can again feel rejuvenated in our spiritual practices and also seek mercy. So we are extremely thankful to Srila Prabhupada that he has blessed us in so many ways. And we are eternally grateful to him for having taken so much effort. And as a token of our gratitude and our affection and love for Srila Prabhupada, we could reaffirm our dedication to our practice of Krishna consciousness and to also help spread the message of joy to all the living entities in the form of Krishna consciousness. So I think it is time, it is 6:18 there. I am presently here in on the West Coast, Washington State. So time here is 18 past 3 for me. So I think I may have exceeded my time. I'm very sorry. I'm very thankful to the management at our Baltimore, ISKCON Baltimore Yatra and the ISKCON Baltimore Temple. I'm very thankful to the deities and to all the devotees for having this opportunity to speak about this festival, this beautiful festival, the Chiradahi Mahotsav, and to be able to glorify Sri Nityananda Prabhu and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Shri Shri Nitai Gaur Chandra Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Hare Krishna. So Neela Madhav Prabhu, if you are there, could you please let me know? Or Shyama Prabhu, should I just sign off? Hare Krishna. Yes, I can hear your voice.
Yes. So we'll be taking a few questions.
Oh.
If you have any questions, they can put it on Facebook or YouTube. I can pass it on to Prabhuji to answer them if anybody has any questions.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, thank you very much. Dandavat Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Guru Maharaj Ki Jai.
Thank you.